Step back, you're losing the light on your face. There you go. There you go. See, you're giving me lessons. It's good. There you go. There you go.
Okay. Greetings. Welcome. Michael Ackerman.
I like my soapbox. Thank you, James. I knew I was going to be here. Thank you, everybody else, for coming. I appreciate you being here. And especially since I didn't know that all this stuff would become part of my life. I've spent a lot of effort digging around inside myself to deal with the things that boil around in me. And this is a piece of what came out. And I had no idea that it would come in the door. I had no idea that it would be more than just something personal for me, and that I would get to speak to other people. And that though one person might say, that's terrible, that's terrible, or vice versa, it was a beautiful thing, and that some piece of me said something to somebody else. And that's really why I do what I do. That's why most artists, whatever their form, music, painting, sculpting, writing, food, making this good stuff, all those things is about, so that we will be in the same time and place like we are right now. Think of all the conversations you guys have had this evening, the ones you're going to have, the new relationships you've begun to build, and it's because of these artistic things. So that's why here in this community, because there's this great friendliness I'm discovering. I've been in the area for 30 years and practiced different parts of my personality in different parts of the county, and I've dealt with it in almost every jurisdiction because of the houses I've built part of my life. And now by being here in Tascadero this last 8 or 9 months, my experiences with the community of whole and the city over some planning building issues and then some ideas about art and what could take place in the community. So I've had great successful relationships everywhere else. This community, city, has been the most welcoming of everywhere I've been. So that's exciting to me. And it says that to me there's something in the offing, something possible for the community here. So I've thrown into the community this concept the last Friday of the month, Colony Art Crawl. The idea being that it's about art, food and wine, and then rolling into music. So this evening you guys will be experiencing that part, not that one. That's my friend of mine, and we've done these things together on many occasions, so I'm very appreciative that Matt is here. And so the thing that comes to my mind now is that thing called playground. We all know what that is. We all did that as kids at our place, and the things we did and we didn't do. So I'm encouraging that we can have a stronger, more unified community, a better playground, if we can pull our diversities together, whether it be my version of art, somebody else's version of art, or somebody else's music, or a different version of music, i.e. all of our different personalities and different ways of doing things. So that's why I'm standing on this box. I appreciate that you're here over my art, but it gives me an opportunity to grow my build, my thing, why can't we just be better for the camera now?
Pose there.
So, I guess that's enough. So that being said, Bill, that's what I want to do now is throw something at
me. I'm wondering about your art therapy.
My art therapy? Yeah. Or props or my own therapy?
The therapy that you do for other people.
So, the little story to build into that. All of this happened because I stopped doing what was successful. Making money, being all that American dream stuff was killing me. And in the slowing down of that, I started listening to myself, and this stuff came out. I didn't have any idea I was going to paint or do those things as a younger person. And so that process of me tuning in was seen by a contractor friend of mine, and so he asked me if I would show him how to paint. He saw what he was doing. So I painted with him, and what I discovered in that process, and I'm going to say the short version, you heard the long version, is that onto the canvas happened for him exactly what happened for me. Why? Letting that artesian well of truth boil around and come out and not be in judgment, it just shoots right onto the canvas. And in his case, I didn't take any pictures. And that taught me to take pictures because the canvas, the story evolves, just like all of us. We want to be static, we want to stay in one spot for life, we want to get to a spot for faith. It's kind of like this. Life is a dynamic, moving thing. It's organic, it happens. It's just a river that goes and goes and goes. You either better learn to float in it, swim across it, or whatever, or you get lost. So the point of the workshops is that I work with somebody such that I, in a way, I disorient them. I take away their normal perception of the world. I heighten their ability to be very present, very trusting of the environment. And then when they come back, so to speak, something explodes out of them. And that's when they start painting. And the purpose of painting is not really about being an artist. It's the fact that, unlike a conversation or an experience, it's a tangible thing that goes along with it, especially if you take a picture. So there's all these deep plot, workshop, personal things that just pour right out on the canvas. And then when the person I'm working with is ready, we start talking about that. And everything comes up, whether it's... What? I'm not loud enough?
Yeah!
All right, thank you. Good friends, thank you. All right, so I'm probably being too wordy because I get that one. So the point here is that with this workshop process, whether it's an individual or a couple or a group, all those issues show up right on the canvas. So if I have them working with one canvas as an individual or a large canvas as a group, very tangible. You have to deal with somebody just painted this, and they're standing back and they're proud of it. Somebody else comes in and goes, "Man, that's right for them." But don't we do that to our husbands, our wives, our children, or if we do that all the time? It's co-creating and trying to find a way to end up with something. So it becomes a very interesting process because, again, you have the photography, you have the painting or paintings to come home with. And it's just an undeniable truth. So that led me to the idea of art always reveals truth. If you're not feeling good, it shows. If you're producing crappy work, it shows. If you're producing really good work, it shows. It's all right there. And so the building throughout, because that's what you're looking at on the wall here. That's, every one of these is a different part of me just dealing with something and going to the canvas. Some cases, things happen very rapidly, like that blue one down in the end. That's paint that I took off of a painting that I laboriously was working on and took that paint to that canvas. And an hour later, that was done. Just like that. And other paintings have sketches and, you know, that one up there I call Promised World. That sketches and then when I started that one, I still didn't own a palette knife or any of those kind of things. The texture you see in there, across the kitchen floor. And so that's the kind of thing that there are tools available to us, whether it be what I just said there or parts of our personality, all kinds of things are right there available, and they're telling us to be used, but we aren't listening. How many of you are going out the door and something that's in your house is saying, I want to go along, but you ignore it, and then 2 hours later you needed that thing? Have you ever had that experience? See, so that's just listening. All right, I'm done with that. So I'm going to ask you to speak louder so I can hear you, because I'm a little deaf. But here's the favor I ask. So I sent some things before, you sent them easy, I already sent something. So would you tell me before I tell you anything what you get, because I get an unadulterated response. And then I'll tell you the story.
Well, I love that public comment, and I don't have to share. Yeah. It feels old, it feels rusty.
That's the thing that's fascinating to me about these kinds of pieces. This one, there's some more over in this end of the room. And these are not actually painting. These are a sheet of galvanized steel, and then other metals and shapes and organic material that have been put on there. And then I use various acids, and then I just pour the acids on. And I move around, and sometimes the acid is so strong, I've got to get out of box. And so, the thing that's so fascinating about this, going back to what I was talking about accessing your artesian well, your energetic flow, just letting what's in you come out. This is so much more abstract than these other things, because I'm not picking a color, or mixing a color, or in that flow, or picking up a brush, or a or whatever. That's acid. And sometimes I pick the piece up and I'm, you know, but I'm doing things with it, but it's so much more just the acid and my energetic sense. There's this newspaper she's looking at down at the other end that had a blessing a week ago where a contemporary house in Cayucas was featured in the trip, and one of my acid metal pieces, copper one, was purchased for the house because it's a contemporary house. And that one I was very interested in, and this is mostly what the metal pieces are about, the impact of the energetic world and man metaphysical structures. So that's why that rectangle thing is there for me. And this particular one, we see the building shapes and these moon earth shapes, but there's this moon moving right through. Yeah. I can't claim to have done it on purpose, but that's what came out, and that was the energy I was in terms of how we're using the world, the stuff we make. Quick. Anything else?
A heart repair?
A whole lot of heart.
A hole in the heart.
A hole in the heart. Bye, Bobby. What was that, Bobby? Come on. Well, I think it's the heart that matters myself. So that's the thing that to me is so fun about somebody saying something about a piece before I say what it is. And so that thing is seen as a heart quite often. I've had others see it as this erupting volcano in an island. And I call that painting Mochi. You guys know what Mochi is? It's a rice ball ice cream, Japanese, my favorite dessert. That painting, like all these, over time has developed its own story. That was hanging in a show one time, and this woman was standing there looking at it, and liked it. Lola's gonna like this, because she's gonna walk the dog, go, why Reggie and I keep laughing when she says she likes that. So this woman was looking at the painting. And her husband walked up, and he's looking at the painting, and she leans into him, and she says, is that what I think that is? And he goes, well, yeah, he's even got the light in it. See, so it is the heart. And it does have a yeah, and that's the beauty of abstract work, and it's really why I work this way, because I'm more interested in the energetic flow of those things that we see and we interpret rather than, you know, that's another tree or another house or a grove or a important person that's very representational. The beauty of photography frees all the rest of us up to do these other things. So that's why we do it. Otherwise, I'd be like how Van Gogh started. He wanted to be a famous portraiture. And he wound up someplace else because other things happened to him. And he allowed himself to do it. He took the risk of being a shitty painter, being outcast. He didn't really sell anything, and we all know the story. So it's true for all of us. We hold ourselves back over so many fears about whether we're going to make money, be liked, or not liked, all that stuff. And I was good at that. I was rather well off financially. I owned multiple pieces of property. I had several businesses, and it was killing me. It was a false sense of success for me. I didn't know this other stuff had to take place. So that's why it was killing me. This was not able to come out. I was that imbalanced. So that's the other thing. Just let those other parts of you out so that you are balanced, so that you are feeding all parts of who you are. Because everybody in here has come from muddy waters and the deep boiling around. And the ethereal beauty. We are all that.